Welcome to Pixotope Academy. Today we'll be discussing cloud licenses. This tutorial will take you through the steps of creating a main customer account where you can then create users and delegate your licenses for the organization. Once you receive your email invitation from a Pixotope representative, you'll be able to create a main user for your organization in the Pixotope Cloud portal. You're going to click Complete Admin Signup, and once you set up a secure password, you'll be able to log in using the Admin Login button. Here in the homepage, we can see the user setup, how many unassigned licenses we have, and when they'll expire. Now, to manage and assign your licenses to team members, you'll first need to select the Add New User button. I'm going to go ahead and add all the members of our team, and then we can go through assigning them with their appropriate licenses. Please note that the email address associated with the admin account cannot be used as a new user to have a license assigned to. All right, so now we've added our team members. We have our live operator who will be on set during the broadcast using Pixotope, our environment artist who's going to be doing the virtual studio work, and one Data Hub account. This will be dedicated to run Data Hub for any multi-machine setups. Now under My Products, we can review what licenses we have available. A remote license allows you to run Director on a separate machine for remote setup and control, but does not include Pixotope Editor. A Pixotope one-year subscription includes one live package and two artist packages. The live package is used in a studio environment to set up and run a show. This is the standard license for broadcasting and is dedicated one per camera. This includes all Pixotope components, including director and editor. The artist package is used in a creative environment where no video input or camera tracking is needed. This is for users who only need to use the editor so that they can assemble 3D content and build levels. All right, now that we're familiar with the different types of licenses available, time to assign them to our team. We'll begin with the Data Hub account. Our Data Hub account is going to be meant to just run the production remotely, so we'll have it run Director on a separate machine and don't need Editor included. For that reason, we're going to give this a remote subscription. All right, now back to users. Our environment artist is going to be focused just on the virtual studio and won't need access to Director for any live production elements, so we're going to assign them the artist license. And finally, we have our live operator. Our live operator will be on set during the production and will need access not only to director for setup and oversight of the production, but also might need access to editor for any technical adjustments that need to happen before the production. So we're going to assign him the live license so he has access to all the Pixotope components. Back on the homepage, you can see we now have an updated total number of users who are registered and remaining licenses. But let's say we need to reassign a license. All we have to do is unassign it from one user and assign it to another. Let's say at one point our environment artist needs to use Director to test out tracking or something with a live camera. What we'll do is go over to Live Operator, and we have unassigned his license. Now if we go back, I can give that license to our environment artist. And now under users, we can see that our environment artist has both a live and artist license. And at any point, you can switch back the license as need be. Once you set up a new user, they'll receive a confirmation email from Pixotope Cloud. There they can access a link to set up a password and access their account. And this is the homepage for any Pixotope user once they sign in. Here you get information about your license. The download tab will provide you with the most current version of Pixotope, as well as all of our prior versions for download. The documentation tab will take you to our PDF archive of all documentation. This also has a link which will take you to our most up-to-date and robust collection of information in the Pixotope Help Center. And now if we go back, we'll select the support tab, and here's where you'll be able to see any open tickets that you have, as well as submit a new ticket using our single sign-on to access the support portal. Here, you'll also be able to search through our database of related articles, user guides, and documentation. And once you submit the new ticket, this will be sent directly to our support team. You can check on the status of your ticket in the Pixotope Cloud for real-time updates. And to help you get started, on the homepage we provide a library of sample projects to help introduce key topics such as virtual studios, augmented reality, data integration, and DMX lighting for virtual scenes. And now you'll be able to manage your licenses, contact support, and view all the documentation through the Pixotope portal. Thank you for watching this video. Please check out our library with more tutorials, tips, and tricks to get the most out of Pixotope with your productions.